G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week we're going to do like a polygon effect, a really cool effect in Affinity photo. Got two photos here from Unsplash. We've got our man here, we've got our headphones here, and this picture is one that I made myself, and I'll show you how to make your own, or you can download this one. I'll have the link in the description below. It'll be absolutely free for you to download. So as usual, let's get started. I'm going to start off with our man here. I'm going to use our flood selection tool here. I'm going to make sure our tolerance is on 15%, and we're just going to click in this area here on the background. You can see it hasn't added this area here, so we're going to come up here to mode where it says add and just click on add and click here as well. So once we've got our selection, come up here to select grow and shrink, and on the grow and shrink box I'm going to choose 8 pixels, hit apply, and that's just going to bring that selection in slightly, so it's just slightly in on the picture, and I think that'll give us a better selection for what we're about to do next. Once we've got our selection, we can simply just hit delete, take all that background away. You can see we've left a little bit of yellow here in the glasses. So since we've got our add still on here, we can just click on the glasses here, hit delete, hit on that little bit of yellow there and hit delete. And then we can get rid of those marching ants. So that's looking pretty good. We've got our man on his own transparent background. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come up to arrange, and I'm going to flip the man horizontal because I want him facing that way for our picture. And I'm also going to add an FX, a layer effect down here, and this little FX here. I'm going to click on FX and I'm going to click on color overlay. And I want him to be silhouetted like that. The other thing I'm going to do is put an outline on our man here. So I'm going to come up here and click on outline. For the colors on outline, I'm going to click on color. And I want that sort of cyan glowing look. I'm going to click on the first one, the red channel here. I'm going to hit 25. Next one, I'm going to type in 176. And then on the last one, 255, and hit enter, and it's going to give me that nice cyan look that I want. Then I'm going to bring my radius up here until I see my blue outline appear. About 13.9, 14 pixels, looking pretty good. I like the way that looks, so I'm going to click off that. I am going to right click while I'm here. I'm just going to rasterize that image. I'm going to click off reserve layer effects. I just want it to be one flat image, so I'm going to go rasterize, and that combines that FX with our background to make it just one background pixel layer. Let's come over here now to our headphones. For this one, I'm going to use my selection brush tool, making my brush a little bit bigger. I'm just using my right and left bracket keys, not too big, just about there, and let's just select those headphones. Should be a fairly quick selection. Make sure we get all the headphones there. Making my brush a little bit smaller because I want the cable as well down here. So just run that down the cable. I don't want this bit here. Hold my option key down and just get rid of that. I just want this square bit here. I'm going to zoom in with my command plus. I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller. Holding my option key down again, I'm just going to select this area in here. All the way down, maybe my brush a little bit smaller as we get towards the end there, and just select that area there. Okay, command 0 to get back to the normal size. Redo our brush a little bit, see if we can smooth this section out a bit. Come up here to invert selection, and then we can go delete. Just to have those headphones on their own layer again. Going to do the same as with my other picture. Going to come down here to layer effects. Firstly, click on color overlay, and we want the color to be black, so we've got that black. Let's come up here to outline and click on outline now. And again, our color, we want that cyan type color, so 25, tab, 176, tab, 255, and enter. Gives us our cyan color. And again, we'll turn up this to about 13.9 or 14. 13.9, we've got a little bit left here. Let's just close that, grab our erase tool and get rid of that straight away. Just get rid of that, we don't need that little bit. And again, I'm going to rasterize this layer as well. So let's rasterize that. Don't preserve the FX, Don't want to do that, and rasterize. Now we've got that done, let's copy this now. So Command C, come back over to our man and Command V. Come up here to our move tool. Let's move our headphones into place. And a bit smaller, just so they fit up here. Maybe a little bit wider. Come up to the top here when you think you've got a good spot. I'm just going to use my warp tool here, just my mesh warp tool. And I'm just going to bring that side down a little bit and try to warp this one into place and hit apply. So the next thing I'm going to come over here to my ellipse tool. I'm just going to draw out a little circle about that big. I'm going to fill it again with that same color. 25, 176, 255, and add that. I'm just going to fill it with that color. On the stroke, I'm going to have the color white. So I'm just going to click white and bring that stroke up a little bit, maybe 4.5. Click on my move tool here. I'm just going to move that into the middle here of my headsets, maybe make it a little bit smaller. I think that stroke needs to be a little bit thicker so we can see it, about 14. So we've got our headset in place, and I'm just going to clip that to the headset as well. Okay, let's come over here to these poly shapes that I've created. And as I said, you can create your own. It's very easy to create. It's just a blank layer creating a whole lot of triangle shape. So we've got our triangle. And I've just drawn out the triangle, and it has got that color as the stroke that we talked about. I've just made the stroke length 2, and the fill is empty, so no fill at all. So fill is all the way down, no opacity on the fill. And then it's just a matter of fitting your shapes together and creating a pattern. This is the one that I've created. It's very simple. As I said, if you don't want to create your own, this one will be available for download. The link will be in the description. So let's grab this shape that I've created, Command C. Come over to our picture and Command V. Now I'm going to take this shape and I'm going to clip it just to the headset at the moment. I'm going to turn it around. I'm going to hold my shift key down so it stays straight. And I'm just going to clip that to my headset here. I'm also going to add an effects on that as well, on this layer. And I'm going to add the outline again with the same colors again. So 25, 176, and 255. Hit enter. And I'm going to bring the radius up. And it just makes those lines a little bit thicker. So you bring them up to as thick as you want. That's looking pretty good. 1 pixel. Just thickened them up a little bit. We can go thicker if we want to. Say 2.4. I'll keep it at 1 pixel for now, and let's close that. So we've got our shape inside of our headset. So now we can do the same to our man, and we can just simply copy this layer now. So Command J, let's bring one of these down and clip it to the man. Clipped it to the man, and let's move this one out a little bit. Good, about there. Let's Command J, another copy. While we're here, we can clip that one to his arm here. Command J again, another copy. Put it at the back here. Command J again. Add one all the way up here. Try not to go over the headset. Gonna need one more. Command J. Place that about here. Now, while we're here, you can change the color of any of these lines that you want to change. So let's change the color on the headset one, just to show you that you can change the color. Click on this polygon effect here underneath the headphones. Let's come down here to adjustments and click HSL. And let's clip that HSL just to that layer there, just the polygon on the headset. And then we can just bring this up and down to change the color. So let's go, maybe the headset there can be green just to make it stand out a little bit. And you can do the same to any of these colors on the man down here as well. So I won't change them now, but all you have to do is take a HSL adjustment and clip it to any of these layers to change the color. So let's just collapse that one. let you change any colors that you want. So the next thing I'm going to do is come over here to my rectangle tool. I'm just going to click on that. Make sure our fill is black. I like to just click on the black swatch here just to make sure it's pure black. I'm going to draw out a rectangle and I want it to be all the way underneath. So there we go. We've got our black color, got our man and our black background. And I'm going to do one more little thing for this picture. I'm going to grab an ellipse, make another circle. This one, I don't want any stroke on it at all. So let's take no stroke. The fill, I want that same color again. 25, 176, 255, and hit enter. I'm going to bring this one all the way down, just under the man and top of the black layer here. Here I'm on my move tool, and it should be behind the man, which I want. So I'm just going to make that quite big, make a circle behind the man. Now, we have a choice here. We can leave it like that, which looks pretty cool. I think I'm going to add a bit of a Gaussian blur on here. So on this ellipse here, I'm going to add a live filter, Gaussian blur. I'm going to make mine 400% and hit enter. And I'm just going to blur that. So there you go, everybody. We've created this really cool polygon effect in Affinity Photo. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial this week. If you have, please give the video a thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel. Hit that little notification bell so you know when I'm putting out a new video. And until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe. I'll see you in my next video.